Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. All weapons will remain locked until departure.
Dead man, you there? Little help.
Okay, Sam. Remove the pod and connect it to that incubator.
It's in.
Good. A temporary excess of stress. Easily addressed if we return it to its mother's womb.
Mother?
Located in the capital, not city, ICU. Brain dead, of course.
You mean still mother?
Correct. A still mother's womb facilitates a connection between the world of the dead and the BB. And you, in turn, connect yourself to a BB, granting you the ability to sense BTs. These pods were designed to simulate the conditions inside a still mother's womb. BBs need to believe they're in one at all times to function properly. However, we can only maintain this deception for so long, which is why we must periodically update the environmental data by synchronizing it with a still mother via the chiral network. There. The update is in progress. Right now, the pod is synchronizing with the Steel Mother in Capital Knot City and reconfiguring its settings based on the latest data. Returning your BB to the womb in this manner will temporarily reduce its stress levels. That being where it technically belongs, of course.
Kid looks happy.
I'll try adjusting the oxytocin dosage. Autotoxemia should set in much slower from now on. You should remember that BBs are just equipment. Try not to get attached. Each one has been physically removed from its steel mother's womb, a process that renders them unpredictable and prone to failure. No BB on record has remained in service for over a year. It may need to be retired before this expedition is over.
And then? You saying there's no way to keep my BB alive?
You must understand, there is still a great deal we don't know about BBs. As we expand the chiral network and recover more past data, perhaps we'll find our answers. Right. You asked me to look into why the BTs might be reacting to your blood. I spoke with Hartman. We should have your results soon. Anyway, get some rest. You and your BB are both exhausted. Good night, Sam.
Can you see me?
How are things over there?
Still not under guard? Still not chained up. Still can't leave. But if you can keep making connections, if you can get to me, we can go back east, back home. Thank you. I mean that. It's bad. There are fewer and fewer people in the cities these days. No one's having children anymore. But humans aren't made for living alone. They're supposed to come together, to help one another. And if we as a people can't do that, if we can't reconnect, then, well, it's like Bridget said, extinction.
Come on. Rebuilding America isn't gonna get rid of the BTs. As long as they're still around, there's no escaping it.
But at least we'll have hope. I'll be waiting, Sam. Waiting for you. Come and find me.
Hello, Sam. This is Hardman. Since you're awake, it might behoove you to freshen up. To that end, why not take a shower? It's good for the body and soul, and also my research, as it happens.
is the future. Some refuse the past. Evilly, it's messed up if we can't unplug the fact that the world covered in cables was never wired to last. So don't act so surprised when the program starts crying. How do I form a connection when we can't even shake hands? You're like a phantom greeting me. We part in the shadows, hang out in the gallows, stuck in a loop for eternity. Do you know why the flowers never bloom? Will you retry or let the pain resume? I need a new leader, we need a new leader. So come outside, it's time to see the tide. It's out of sight, but never out of mind. Today I'm kinda feeling like a ghost. Call my friends but ain't nobody home. Tell myself I'm fine but I don't really know. I'm just scared that I'll end up alone. I never let it show, but I feel like a missed call on the phone. Trying to live my life as you go, but I'm so scared that I'll end up alone. You know I'm like a ghost, sometimes I have to fade. And it haunts me that I have to feel this way. You say it's gone cold, I say I'll do better, but I always seem to disappear again. You know I'm like a ghost, I see it in your face.
You okay?
And it haunts me that I have to feel this way. You say it's gone cold, I say I'll do better, but I always seem to disappear again. You know I'm like a ghost. You know I never meant to cut you off. Got phantom feelings I can never stop. Stranger things to worry about, I know. But I'm so scared that I'll end up alone. Can't see myself in the mirror. Does that mean I'm not really here? I'm losing touch with everything I know. And I'm so scared that I'll end up alone. You know I'm like a ghost, sometimes I have to fade.
Study other people with dooms?
Everyone in Bridges, myself and Mama. Results thus far are inconclusive. But you possess other singular qualities, being a repatriate as well. I must confess to a measure of optimism.
Processing fluids, waste products, dry relic, dispensing.
There, take the sample with you. Should the opportunity arise, try using it on a BT. I'm curious to see how they react. Who knows, it may even prove beneficial to you. There was an old research paper detailing the effects of bodily fluids from individuals like us on BTs. It is only by recovering these materials that we can unearth the knowledge of the past. Not just the Death Stranding, but also the mystery of your body's unique properties and even our doom's affliction. There may well be hope for humanity. Sam, I have no interest in rebuilding America. I want to recover the past.
Five.
Oh,
four,
it's almost time.
Two, one.
After you make your connections and nothing happens, then what? I said, then what?
Sam, sorry to bother you while you're taking a break, but I figured you'd want to hear this. Hell, maybe it'll help you rest easier. We received a number of messages addressed to you. I've not taken a look myself, but I gather they're mostly from your clients. You should see if they contain any useful information. Mail can be accessed via your cufflinks, as well as the terminal in your private room. There's something else I'd like to share with you. With the Chiral Network, we now have the power to reclaim our past. Data once thought lost forever from every corner of America can be pieced back together from fragmented records. Our archives are still a work in progress, of course. But as we expand the network and integrate more way stations and cities, we'll be able to recover more and more information, such as the previous expedition's logs and reports. Everything they sent back was lost when Central Knot City was destroyed. Now we've managed to restore some already, in fact. You can access them from a private room terminal or your cufflinks by selecting Archives. Might make for interesting reading.
Tell you why we ain't getting high no more. Try so hard. There's something I've been feeling and we're lonely, but we never used to be. Either we're arguing or you leave. We both know something's missing. I've been holding on to nothing. You don't care too much, and it's obvious they already gone. So unleash your weapon, aim it at my chest then. If I love is a drug, you're the one with the trigger. Shoot me down, I don't want.
Everything in your power to save BB.
We are. But we cannot release your son just yet. Believe me when I tell you it's for the best.
Says the woman in the mask who's done nothing but lie to me.
Something I forgot to tell you. It's about managing your BB stress levels and reducing the risk of autotoxemic attacks. There are a few things you can do if your BB starts showing signs of distress.
Such as?
Such as take a moment to look after it. Cradle the pod, gently rock it, that sort of thing. Out of curiosity, how's it doing at the moment?
Before I answer that...
Something wrong?
When I hook up my BB, I see things.
What kind of things?
Like a face, someone I don't know, calling to me. There's this room, too, with other people talking, but I can't make out the words.
Bleed-through effect. Didn't I warn you about this? You're mistaking the BB's memories for your own. They're false flashbacks, nothing more. Let me explain. A BB is harvested from its steel mother at around 28 weeks and placed in a pod. To be clear, this is before it's even born. The procedure halts its development. But even at 28 weeks, its sensory systems have matured enough to process external stimuli. It is more than capable of encoding this information into memories, which can bleed into yours via your connection.
So who's the man I saw?
Someone from the medical team, maybe? Or a BB technician? Does it matter? The BB has been in circulation for a while now. It's been handled by a lot of people. How should I know which one made an impression?
'Cause you're the expert.
No one's an expert, Sam. BBs were developed decades ago in secret. They're your quintessential black boxes. We may use them, but we don't truly understand them. Believe me, I've been trying to learn more, but almost all of the old records are gone. If I find anything out, I'll tell you, all right? Dead man's honor.
Huh.
While you're resting, I ran some network diagnostics. Corellia monitoring and holographic systems are nominal. Unfortunately, our printer is offline. I know, after all the trouble you went through to bring us those materials. This one's on us. We ordered a part a while back, but it never arrived. The printer needs it to communicate with the chiral network. Mules must have snatched it, caught that porter en route or something. If I'm right, they'll have taken it to their drop site, which is smack dab in the middle of their territory. Don't suppose you'd be up for stealing us our property back? Can't think of anyone more qualified than you.
Sam, the area around that distro center has produced a significant quantity of chiral crystals. Matter of fact, that's where the chirellium used in your Cupid's internal circuitry came from. They have a range of applications, including equipment fabrication. Bottom line, they're a valuable resource and one you'll want to make the most of. I'll let Hartman explain in more detail, but chiral crystals don't exactly grow on trees. If you see any deposits, you should go out of your way to gather them. Especially since folks with dooms are the only ones that can. Provided they have the necessary equipment, that is. I'll see that it's added to your supplies for this order.
Sam, it's Hartman. Following the discovery of the beach, we not only began to observe heretofore unseen phenomena, but a new type of matter. Chirellium. I say new, but it has doubtlessly existed since the dawn of the universe. We believe it was always there, like dark matter and certain particles. Ever-present, yet overlooked because we lacked the capacity to see it. Chirellium appears to be unbound by the constraints of physics as we understand them. It can stop time or move contrary to it. On occasion, it even defies gravity. In practical terms, it can stop or even reverse time and causes objects to float. A special cylindrical case is required to collect and store it. Suffice it to say, the procurement of samples is vital to our ongoing research.
Heads up, Sam. Distro Center staff's got a favor to ask. Probably best I start from the beginning.
This one's on us. We ordered a part a while back, but it never arrived. The printer needs it to communicate with the chiral network. Mules must have snatched it, caught that porter en route or something. If I'm right, they'll have taken it to their drop site.
Mama's added a watchtower schematic to your PCC. If you don't have it on you, consider fabricating one. You never know when you'll need to recon an area. Crystal collector. Now, as the name suggests, it provides secure storage for any crystals you gather.
Allow me to describe your quarry. Chiral crystals appear gold to the naked eye and are frequently found in formations resembling human handprints. The surrounding rocks and debris tend to float a few feet above the ground. And they are most commonly found in areas with high precipitation,
Got all that? Hmm? Rain, floating rocks, golden handprints. That's your trifecta. Look for these three things and you'll find the crystals. If you've been especially observant, then perhaps you already know where to look.
Order assigned. Beginning scan. Have a pleasant journey. Restrictions lifted. Call it a rule or a habit, but most mules almost always bring stolen shipments home with them. Find the post box, steal back the cargo. Simple as that. But be careful, these guys are armed. If this goes sideways, be ready to fight.
There we go.
Drop site. We recommend you use a watchtower to confirm the location of the post box containing our cargo. Drop sites are rarely deserted, so remaining undetected is key. Keep a low profile and move slowly to minimize noise.
Huh.
damn addicts chasing a cargo high. Shame we gotta deal with their bullshit at all. Back in the day, AI did everything. Deliveries were handled by unmanned vehicles and drones. And all we had to do was sit back and let them work. It was revolutionary. Damn near singularity. No reason for it not to take off. But it didn't. People didn't like it when we took the human element out of the service industry. So, after some consideration, we put it back in. Made jobs no one really needed and gave them to folks who couldn't live without them. And from there, it snowballed. Now we got cults of cargo chasing. Crazies and get off on hijacking shipments. Jackal's always on the lookout for the next porter. Make sure you're not him.
Cargo verified. Thank you.
Weapons restrictions lifted. Beginning scan. Scanning bridges ID. Verifying ID. Clear. Weapons detected. All weapons will be locked until departure. Cargo verified. Thank you.
Sam, pyrocrystal deliveries are a little different from the usual. The process is pretty simple, though. Access the delivery terminal to drop off any pyrocrystals you're carrying.
Time to get that chiral printer in working order. Sorry to push you through so much trouble, but trust me, it'll be worth it. Excellent. The unit doesn't have a scratch on it. Never doubted you'd come through for us.
Sam, how are your shoes holding up? Not too well, I imagine, conditions being what they are out there. Nothing ruins your day like shoes falling apart while you're on the job. Carry on like that, and it's only a matter of time before you injure yourself. I've arranged for boots to be added to your supplies. Bridges standard issue, so they ought to fit you fine. You should always carry an extra pair. But if you forget or run into trouble, you can fabricate another via a terminal at one of our many facilities. Good work, Sam. It seems your connection level is increasing. As your connection level increases, larger quantities of resources will be made available to you at our facilities.
Congratulations, Sam. I understand you now have access to a chiral printer. An extraordinarily useful device that can only function because of the manner in which our network utilizes the beach, enabling us to transfer massive volumes of data instantaneously. Since under normal circumstances, such transfers would take hours, if not days, some have speculated that the chiral network might, in essence, be a time machine. That it is transmitting data into the past. Suffice it to say, we have yet to fully grasp the fundamental nature of the network and the beach which we have come to rely upon. One might liken our relationship with it to that of primitive man's with fire. Is it useful? Quite. Is it dangerous? Undeniably so. Nevertheless, we have decided that the reward outweighs the risk. Furthermore, as the BTs are linked to the beach, it stands to reason that further study and experimentation could be of considerable benefit. The same could be said regarding you, of course. Rest assured, I will keep you apprised of what I learn. You have my word.
Good work.
For us? These crystals only form in places with elevated carillion levels, which makes me wonder if expanding the network had something to do with it. Damn, son. That is a lot of crystals. Maintenance and R&D will both get their fill, looks like.
Excess chiral crystals can be deposited at any facility. They'll be added to the stores held on site. These local stores include materials that you can draw upon to fabricate equipment as needed.
Container repair spray for patching up cargo containers. Good for dealing with timefall degradation and all that. Useful stuff if you and your cargo have been through the ringer. We've added it to your supplies list, so it's readily available if and when you need it.
There is a correlation between elevated Corellium levels and increased crystal formation. This may well be the result of the network's expansion. You needn't worry though, local chiral density is still within an acceptable range. If you find any more, be sure to collect it. You'll be well rewarded.
If you come into more chiral crystals, you can submit them at one of our facilities. And you can deposit other resources too, along with any items you don't need. Everything has its value. What we don't use as is can be broken down into components for R&D and other applications.
We've added a bridge schematic to your PCC. The first step is laying the foundation. After which, you'll have to supply additional materials to finish the job. Plenty of rivers and canyons could do with a good bridge, you know. Take a stroll across one you built yourself, and I guarantee you'll be glad you made the effort. Give it a try. Looks like some cargo has been transported to its destination on your behalf. You can access the share locker to collect it.